Hey guys, what's going on? This is Aries, and I'm doing Fallout New Vegas. I thought I was going to do Stalker. I did some of it, played it for a little while, and I didn't really get into it. As far as this Let's Play, it's pretty slow-paced, so it would seem, you know, something else for something that I would just play on my own. I'll go back to it maybe, but I know Fallout New Vegas well, so I think it would make a much better Let's Play. So let's go ahead and get on in it.
Changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
I gotta say, that's one hell of a way to start a game, and probably would have had a much bigger impact on me when I first played it if I hadn't seen it. Oh, caravan packed items. I think I'm gonna use that just because, you know, fuck it. It's not a walkthrough.
You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now.
Hold on now. If any of you have not known, I have installed a new operating system since I last played New Vegas. Oh, fuck that. Very hard, guys. First person, hardcore mode, true iron sights. Display? I prefer blue, just because that's how I played Fallout 3 in. Sorry, I didn't think I'd have to go through this again. Dialogue subtitles, general subtitles. Alright, and let me just turn down the audio a little bit. I don't want it to be overbearing. Okay.
Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name?
Ooh, we need a nice name.
Can you tell me your name?
Name. It's gonna be Ares. Is awesome. Let's go for it.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name.
I'm Doc Nick. He just doesn't understand.
Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework. You better tell me if I left anything out of place.
I'm sorry, guys, after playing through this game about... This is my fourth or fifth playthrough. It's kind of getting old. This whole part right here. Yeah, usually the only thing that I change is the hair. Usually I get something like not retarded. It's kind of my aim. I'll go for it. Sued. I always go for chocolate. Bam. Okay. And I'm not into facial hair.
Well, I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet.
Alrighty.
Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there.
He's going
now
to test my vigor.
Ain't a race.
Ew. Hell yeah, it's a race, man.
Looking good so far.
Actually, you know what? I'm gonna rob you first.
We'll learn right quick if you get back all your faculties.
Okay. So, pretty much I've been working on this build. You guys didn't see it in like my getting started walkthrough if you watched that. But it's something that I have been kind of working on for a while. So I put luck at 9, I put charisma at 1, perception at 1, intelligence I put at 10, and I forget the rest of my allocations. I think I put 7 as strength, and 7 as agility. Okay, I might have had to go look this up, because I can't exactly always remember what I use. Okay. Yeah, that's it. So I'm like super lucky and super intelligent, so. Yeah. Alrighty. Broken. It's broken, but it can be... Hey, cool. I had high enough prepared to do that. Alright, now I'm gonna make some stim packs. See, isn't it good that Ares knows this game, like, every single nook and cranny? Yeah.
Alright.
I'm gonna be honest, guys, I'm gonna skip this because it's not funny. Like, Fallout 3, their test, it was funny. Like, incredibly. This is just kind of it's actually a psychological test. And doing that, it always puts melee, speech, and survival. Two of those I would never use, even if I was forced to. And I'm going to throw on... I think I'm just going to do a regular guns walkthrough. So...
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
Alrighty. So let's go with... I don't understand why you would want four eyes. That seems like a weird perk. Perception's useless, anyway. Okay, so we're gonna go with Kamikaze because I like VATS. And, I also like Good Natured because it gives you... Ugh, I hate doing scrolls. So it gives you +5 to barter, medicine, repair, and science. And then it takes away it from... 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so... It pretty much takes away energy weapons I never use, explosives I never use, guns I do use, melee weapons I never use. So I get 4 skills that I use a ton, and 1 skill that it's detracted from. So I think it's very beneficial. And I also don't like taking like Fast Shot or Built to Destroy or anything like that. They're not useful to me.
All right, I guess that about does it. Mm-hmm. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Okay. I really don't like the music they play in here. It's like the only time in the game that you hear this, like, kind of like sad and, you know, kind of disturbing. We're gonna take that knife. No. Knife. Okay. I think we're good.
Here, these are... I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. Never was much my style, anyway. I reckon... Anyway, you ever...
I'm not gonna play on hardcore just because it's, like, stupid. If you want an explanation of the definition of stupid, it's... Unless you're going for the achievement, there's no reason to play on it. It doesn't make the game legitimately more difficult. It makes it legitimately more stupid. Like, I don't want to fast travel to a water source every time I'm thirsty.
Might I say you're looking fit
as a fiddle?
Can't say that I'm...
Alright, so that's Victor. He's a robot. We're going to meet him a lot more times. That conversation was kind of stupid, though, so I don't really care. We're gonna try and steal stuff when we can.